Hey, Stargazers, welcome back. My name is Nick. I'm a theaters manager at the Adler Planetarium, and you're watching Skywatch Weekly. Well, this week, before we look up together, I'd like to take a brief moment to say thank you. There are billions of galaxies in the universe, so we're saying a billion thank yous to everyone who helped Adler raise over $129,000 during our year-end fundraising campaign. That's 2.5 times more than our original goal. Special thanks this week go out to Alan and Mary Alice Bloom, David Schroeder, William Davis, Matthew Ephraim, and James Dixon. Thank you for believing in our mission, for supporting our online programs, and for continuing to help us bring space science to everyone, everywhere. Thank you. Well, this week we're going on a safari of sorts, looking at a collection of animals all clustered around the constellation of Orion the Hunter. Now, it's quite a menagerie. We've got 2 dogs, a bull, a dove, a rabbit, and even a unicorn thrown in for good measure. Now, Orion and these other wintertime constellations are easily seen in the evening sky right now. We're going to fast forward to about 9:30 here in Chicago. That's when Orion will be at its highest point in the south. Let's use Orion's belt, this eye-catching line of 3 stars, to point to a few things. First, we'll point up and to the right to this bright star we've covered before, Aldebaran, the eye of Taurus, the bull. This star sits on one of the arms of a V shape in the sky, marking the face of Taurus, and his horns extend that V out from there above Orion. Taurus is one of the zodiac constellations, so you'll often find planets and even the moon among the stars of this constellation. In fact, on Saturday evening, give a look for the waxing gibbous moon right near Aldebaran. Continuing with the bright stars, our second animal can be found pointing with the belt the other way, to this bright star here, in fact the brightest star in the nighttime sky. Its name is Sirius. Sirius is sometimes called the dog star, as it is the brightest star in the constellation of Canis Major, the big dog. This is one of Orion's hunting companions as he treks across the sky. The star Sirius is very bright and easily seen through light pollution. You might have heard the term dog days of summer. This comes from an ancient belief that the combined light of the sun and Sirius led to the hottest days in the northern summer. Although this effect isn't real, the sun and Sirius are in the sky at the same time during much of the summer. We've talked before about how many of the stars that appear to be single to our eyes are in fact double or multiple star systems. Sirius is no exception, but the discovery of its companion has an interesting story with the Chicago connection. The presence of a smaller star in the Sirius system had been deduced in 1844, but it wasn't observed until 1862 by the telescope maker Alvin Graham Clark. He saw it while testing the lens that eventually was installed at the Dearborn Observatory at the old University of Chicago. In 1887, that telescope was moved to Northwestern University in Evanston. The original tube and mount were replaced in 1911, and when the Adler Planetarium opened in 1930, these were placed on permanent loan. The tube and mount are still on display at Adler, so when we reopen our doors to the public, make sure to come on down and check them out. And the telescope lens that first observed that white dwarf companion of Sirius is still in use at the Dearborn Observatory at Northwestern. When things open up again, check out the free public observing sessions at the observatory, where you can look through that historic telescope. Well, if Canis Major is the big dog, there's got to be a little dog, and here he is, Canis Minor. This is just a little puppy dog, marked by essentially 2 stars, one quite dim, and the other quite bright. The bright one is called Procyon, and it is the 8th brightest star in the night sky, and 6th brightest from Chicago's latitude. Procyon would probably be much more striking if it didn't have all these other very bright stars around it. Sirius, Rigel, and Capella are all brighter, and Betelgeuse is slightly dimmer, but it's quite distinctive with its reddish-orange glow. This really is a remarkable part of the sky, with 5 of the 7 brightest stars and 9 of the 15 brightest visible from Chicago's latitude, all visible at one glance. Canis Minor is certainly tiny, but this little puppy dog is depicted in star atlases often in very cute ways, and can be imagined to be hurrying to catch up to Orion and the big dog as they hunt. Or perhaps he's hitching a ride on a fantastic but elusive creature, the unicorn. Monoceros the unicorn is right in between Sirius and Procyon. This mythical beast is certainly dim. From light-polluted skies, there's a good chance you won't see any of these stars in the constellation. And from darker skies, there isn't really much of a shape to trace out. In this case, though, I think that's kind of right. Just like any magical creature, there's a good chance you wouldn't see the unicorn, even if you were looking right at it. For such a dim constellation, it holds some really amazing objects, though these are mostly beyond the bounds of backyard telescopes. These include the Rosette Nebula, a beautiful star-forming region with a cluster of newborn stars at its heart. Also the Christmas Tree Cluster, with a bright star-forming area taking on the shape of a decorated Christmas tree. And at the top, the inverted shape of the Cone Nebula. This cone is 7 light-years tall, and potentially has a region of star formation at its tip. Well, Orion and the dogs may have missed the unicorn in their midst, but what are they hunting? Orion is often shown facing off against Taurus the bull, but perhaps he was hunting some smaller, quieter prey before the bull came along. Below his feet is a quiet rabbit, Lepus the hare. This constellation is only slightly brighter than the unicorn, but from darker skies, with some imagination, you can maybe trace out a rabbit in the stars. We have one last animal to spot in this area, but it is quite low from mid-northern latitudes and also quite dim. This is Columba the dove. This constellation doesn't appear on star maps until the late 1500s, so it's a relative latecomer to this area. It's dim and easily missed, but worth at least a glance just below Lepus the hare. So we have a whole host of creatures surrounding Orion the Hunter. From most skies, Monoceros the unicorn, Lepus the hare, and Columba the dove are going to be a bit of a trick to see. But my challenge for you this week is to see the others, Taurus the bull and Canis Major and Minor, the hunting companions of Orion. Well, that's what we have for you this week. Thanks, as always, for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, if you haven't already, to Adler's YouTube channel, and also follow us on social media. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next week.